Are you gonna make love to me or not? Are you going to make love to me or not?
What? Come on, I'm just getting sleep.
It's your turn to make love to me.
I owe you.
You owe me two already.
How do you figure I owe you two?
Let's see. Last Friday, and the Wednesday before that, when Ron stayed over and you didn't want to make any noise.
All right, I'll leave three. Now leave me alone. Look for it.
Johnny.
Luma. I'm not in the mood right now.
All right. Fine. You don't want to. I don't want to make you do anything you don't want to do. Again.
Put the cigarette out and go to sleep.
Can't sleep when I'm like this.
Tell me about it.
No, it's not. I feel sexy.
It's just nerves. Take a sandwich. You want to. Thank you, thank you. Oh my, cut it out. Good morning. Good morning.
I'm not interested in the morning. It's not romantic in the morning. It's romantic now.
To me, it's work.
Johnny, when I owe you, you pick the time. You owe me, so I pick now.
Who are you kidding? You never pick the time. Last night, we're on our way home from Jersey. I offered to pull off the Pulaski Skyway and get something going, and you said no.
I'm a married woman with two children. I'm not gonna make love in the backseat of a Volkswagen.
And don't complain to me about the lack of variety.
Johnny, Saturday night. We haven't made love in 10 days. We've both worked very hard to make love at least twice a week. If we don't do anything tonight, it's gonna be a lot of pressure on us to catch up.
I've had an unusually upsetting week. Wednesday, I was dizzy at a meeting, and last night I didn't want to go out because it was too hot, and I felt flushed at the party. I am physically and emotionally exhausted.
You know, you sound exactly like my mother complaining to my father.
Oh yeah? Well, you sound exactly like my father making sexual demands on my mother.
It's all right by me if he's the sexy one.
Sexier than you'll ever be.
So why are you hoarding it?
Maybe I wouldn't if you wouldn't nag me so much.
Nag? I have done everything but nag. I have suggested, implied, rubbed up against you while passing, worn provocative nightgowns, perfumed my underwear. I have tried every subtle way to reach you, short of showing stag films.
Well, I'm beginning to think you're trying to make my virility look impotent.
Huh. When did that feeling first hit you?
The day I married you. I was dynamite with other women.
Oh, yeah. They were lucky just to be in there with the holder of the 3-second record in intercourse.
All the women in the world. I had to marry the equal time orgasm fanatic. You read a couple of ladies' home journal and all of a sudden, all you know is me too.
Why not me too?
Look, try to castrate me. It's too much man here. You and your Me Too and your cockamamie career. Me and the kids aren't enough for you. You need the aid of fulfillment to give meaning to your existence. This man is fond of oneself.
So quit your job.
You really want to take over, don't you? Nothing could happen noticing you with your new wardrobe, with your suits and your ties and your new pants and your butch haircut.
Butch? I am more feminine than you will ever be.
You know how feminine you are? Whenever we go out, I light your cigarette for you. I pull out your chair. I rise when you come from the little girl's room, only for you to yell, waiter, check. And when I call a cab, in a snowstorm while you stand under an awning because your feet are too cold and your hair is too wet. But if I take more than 2 minutes to call a cab, you run out in the street and yell, taxi. That. Whenever I try to treat you like a lady, you respond by acting like, Rocky Graziano.
All I wanted was a little tenderness.
Well, look who wants tenderness, little Miss Locker Room Mouth. You better decide who you want to be, a man or a woman, and then talk tenderness to me, Wilma. Oh, or is it Willie?
You know what? Why don't you pick, and I'll take what's left. Oh, you think you're so masculine, because whenever we have a problem, you roll over and go to bed, or you go out and get drunk with the guys. React tough toward me. Well, I got a new slash for you. Those Marine Corps drill sergeants are the biggest bunch of fags in the world.
What would you say about the Corps? Oorah!
Okay.
They're the biggest bunch of latent fags in the world. They're not real men. A real man is warm and understanding and kind and gentle and sweet and sensitive. And loving, and...
And what's a woman?
A woman is brave and strong and...
And what?
A woman is strong and brave in certain situations. Like, when her husband acts tough toward her, she has to act tough toward him. But otherwise, a woman should be worshipped and admired and put up on a pedestal. But she should have the freedom to come down off that pedestal because a woman's independent. But she should be able to go back up on that pedestal because a woman isn't a slave anymore and she wants to be taken care of.
Excuse me, is that taken care of up on the pedestal or down off the pedestal?
Nope, I don't know. I don't know what a woman is. I don't see much difference between us anymore.
Tell you what, next week is your birthday. How about I take you down and get some hormone shots?
What you need is a major transplant.
You know, you want to know why you're so confused? Because you forgot who I am and who you are. I'm the man, and you're just the woman. And the man is the boss. You said so yourself when you got married.
I was just humoring you. I said, if it were so important to you, I'd let you be the boss.
Let me be the boss. I am the boss.
Don't be juvenile. There is no boss.
I'm the boss, and you know it.
There's no boss, and that's final. I don't want to hear another word about it. We're equals.
Oh, we're equals, huh?
Yes, we're equals.
Okay, equal. Let's just see how equal we are. Come on, equal. Let's go a few rounds.
Let go of me.
We're equals, right? Let go of yourself.
Stop it.
Who's the boss?
There's no boss.
Who's the boss?
I am.
Who's the boss?
Stop it. You're going to wake up the kids.
Who's the boss?
You can torture me. I'm not going to say.
And who won?
You did? Shh.
That doesn't bother me at all. Because I won, and I'm the boss. Now, be a good little loser. Let's go to bed. Good night, loser.
plastic bag. Drifting through the wind, wanting to start again. Do you ever feel this so paper thin? Like a house of cards, one blow from caving in. Spark in you, you just gotta ignite the light.